Welcome to PC Mac. Today we will talk about an interesting subject, that is how we can install or how we can run Android OS on our Windows computer and Mac OS. So let's do it. Before we start, I would like you to go ahead and click on the subscribe button. It's free and you can just go ahead and click on the bell icon for my latest videos. So let's get started. First of all, we need to download two tools on our computer. Let me just show you. I have already downloaded the softwares. The name of the first software is Knox Setup and the second one is Limon CPU VWin. That is the software, that is two software that we need to download. So first of all, let's go and download the first one. Let me just show you from where you need to download. So it's Leo Moon. Just go ahead and search for it. You just need to go here. And it will look like this. You just need to go down and download this software. The file will be downloaded like this. You need to open it. And when you open this software, it will let you know that your computer is VD supported, that is virtualization supported or enabled or not. So I'm using an i7 processor on which the virtualization is enabled, and I'm using a 64-bit architecture computer right here on my machine. So if you're seeing both check here, then you can go ahead and install this software on your machine and you can use the Android on your computer. So let's go ahead and do that. Let me close this and let's go ahead and open the second website, that is Knox. Once we click on it, so the first website is right here, free Android emulator on PC and Mac. So you can use it on both the computers, like on Mac as well and on your Windows computer as well. So this software is for both the machine. When you open the website, it will detect that you are using a Windows computer, and if you want to go to Mac version, you just need to click here for the Mac version and it will take you to the Mac website and start downloading the DMG file like this. Let me go ahead and cancel it because I'm using Windows and I already downloaded the file. You already see the download link right here. Let me go ahead and close it, and first of all, let's just go ahead and install the Knox setup. And yes, so the setup and start installing, when we click on this, it might take 1 minute to install the complete software. And as you can see, it's moving fast. It will take only 1 minute or less than that. Yep, it will take around 10 more seconds. So if you have a better configuration of your computer, you can install it and use with your Windows computer and it will work absolutely fine. So it will be installed now, and once we click on start, it will open the emulator for us like this, and it's configuring itself. In a moment you will see everything there. Let me go ahead and maximize it. First of all, you can minimize the themes from here. From here you can download the themes. We are here on the applied theme, the first one. If you like the other themes, you can download and use them. Let's just show you how to download this theme. So we will have two themes on the computer. In between, just minimize this, and as you can see, it's right here. If you want, you can skip the tutorial or just go ahead and see what all things you have. As you can see, it's showing us the apps and everything. So it's done, then got it. So as you can see, the setup is in front of you like this. You have the setup. Now we'll go into themes, as we already downloaded one theme. Let's go ahead and apply it and check how it look like. So let's just go back, and you can see the theme right here. Let me just go ahead and maximize it so I can show you in the full view. So as you can see, the Play Store icon is right here. When we click on it, it will take us right here, and when we search and download for anything like this, we need to add our account. So let's go ahead and try my existing account. So you can select the choices as per your requirement. If you want to backup the data to your Google account, you can select this option. I don't want to do that from my computer, and then no thanks. So now, as I'm connected to my email address here on this emulator, that is the Knox player, so it detects my apps automatically. And let's go back and check whether it installed any app or not. So when we click here on tools, or we click here, so now it asking you to allow the permissions. So let's allow. Now we have allowed the permission. Now I'll try to install Subway Surfer and check whether I'm able to install it or not. So as you can see, the download begin, and it might take some time to install. In between, let's go ahead and check the other options. Like from the top, there are lots of options, system info and other things. We can go into settings. There are general settings like this. You can go through these settings, and you can also select the screen resolution. Right now I'm using 1280x720, so I can also go for 1920x1080 because I'm using a graphics card on my machine. So I can go to the topmost level. Let's just save the setting and restart it. Now as you can see, the graphics become better. Now let me just maximize it, and as you can see, the whole thing is working absolutely fine. Let's go into Play Store one more time and then check Dr. Driving. Is I be able to install it or not? Let's just try to install it. Accept. And as you can see, it start downloading. The download is pending. It might take some time because we are using the emulator. Once it's installed, you can easily play the games on your computer. Let's check how much time it will take. You can drag down from the top like we'll do on our Android phones, and as you can see, it's only says 6 minutes left. And you can check our settings from here, like our Android phones. Let's just go back. You can drag it to the top. In between, let's go ahead and check the other options. This is the back button on the bottom, and this one is the home button. When you press it, you will be go on to home. And this is the recent tab button. When you click on it, you will see all the recent tabs. You can close them by just dragging them down, and again press the home button and you will see the home. Now here is the other things, like shake, and then keyboard from here, then other options like my computer. You can maximize and minimize the volume. You can use the cut. And as you can see, when we select the keyboard, we have the input. So we can input here and we can close it here. So to go out from the keyboard layout, you just need to press the escape and then press yes or no. If you want to save it, then press yes. If you don't want to save it, then click on no and we will be out from the keyboard control. Then here are lots of options. You can capture the images like this and you can rotate the screen for a phone just like that, and you can go into menu. So there are lots of things that you can use. Now let's go ahead and check that the Subway Surfer is downloaded or not. It will take around 6 more minutes to install. We will wait. In between we'll check the other features, that you can use Facebook here and you can check all the contacts from here as well. So I'm connected to my phone through this emulator, so all the data on my phone can be synchronized on this machine as well. And here is the browser. You can go for the browser from here. You can look for Google. Now you can use your keyboard and use it. Let's search for my channel. And as you can see, the browser is also working absolutely fine. So here is my Pinterest account. So let's go ahead and close this. So overall, the Android emulator is working absolutely fine, and I'm just waiting for the Subway Surfer to complete. If you have a camera attached to your PC, you can use the camera. Right now no camera is attached to my computer. Then let's just go back, and there are tools like gallery. So I have took one screenshot, so it's showing that. Let's go back. Here is Google settings and game settings, and the other things are here. You can go ahead and check by yourself. If you see any problems with this Knox player, you can go ahead and write me in the comment section. I'll try to answer your comments. And let's just wait until it's complete. So Subway Surfer is installed, and as you can see, the first app that we are trying to install, Dr. Driving, is also installing. It will take only 57 seconds. In between, just go ahead and check how Subway Surfer work. So I started the game. It's loading now and I'm using my mouse. I don't know whether it will work or not. I need to check the settings for it because it's not working with the mouse. So we need to go through all these settings, how we can play this game. So that will be shown to you in the next video. Let me just go back because I don't want this video to be a really long video. Let's just go ahead and check the other game. Let's just drag it from the top and check that we have the Dr. Driving installed or not. So it's installed. Let's go ahead and check. So let's check whether we are able to configure it or not. Let's check the motion control and we'll see that we are able to play this or not. Yeah, I think I'm able to play this. Okay, let's try to play it again. It's accidentally close by itself. So I have changed the settings here. Now let's see whether we are able to play the game or not. Okay, so it's working fine. As you can see, we are able to use the steering now. So I busted now. So the mission is failed. You can try to use this emulator on your PC or on your Mac, and you can also try to play these games. And if you face any problem, you can let me know in the comment section. If you like my video, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. And thank you for watching. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.